Schindler Lawn Care and Landscaping. Contact them at 515-320-3840 or schindlerlawncare@gmail.com.
Premier Pizza, located in downtown Algona.
All bringing you this tournament broadcast.
For the second year in a row, it's Bishop Garrigan against GTRA in the first round of the postseason. I'm Tyler Lance alongside Beanie Bodie. We welcome everyone tuning into our stream and even those who have jumped over from the first game of our doubleheader, North Union against North Iowa, as North Iowa won that game by a final score of 50-28. So winner of tonight's matchup will face North Iowa. We'll get into some more pregame coverage coming up next, as right now we'll hear from Bishop Garrigan head coach Mark Meister and his thoughts on tonight's game.
We are getting ready for high school playoff basketball tonight between Bishop Garrigan and GTRA. And right now I'm talking with Golden Bear head coach Mark Meister. Coach, just first of all, I know the team didn't end the season quite the way they wanted to with that three-game losing streak, but overall, how do you feel the guys' confidence is coming into tonight's game?
Well, I wish we'd have got a few more down the stretch, but the first half of the season, you know, to start 0-8-9 or 1-9, whatever that was, and end the season with as many wins as we did, you know, we played about 500 basketball on the way out, and we were in about, you know, every game, a lot of single-digit losses. I don't know if a lot of people realize we had our conference meeting last weekend, and in that we ended up losing those games all season by about a point or less. Well, our thing again, if you're in every game that tight, you know, for us it's been our turnover. So I think that's the thing we're still kind of working on. And there's games when we play that defense really hard, you know, and we're creating less turnovers. That's our strong suit. So nights when that's happening, it kind of seems like then the shots start to fall, and then we're, you know, way, way more competitive when that defense kind of carries over for us.
Now, Coach, you go into tonight's matchup against GTRA. Now that you've had a few days to look at the Titans, what stands out to you about them?
Well, they were in our summer league, so we've seen them quite a bit. We played them last year in the tournaments. Pretty much the same team back, so an experienced team. Their strong suit, you know, is good guard play, good shooting, so we're going to have to throw a few different defensive ideas at them instead of, you know, kind of packing it and giving up those shots. We're kind of going to have to do a reverse where we're three-pointers and make them go in, you know, where they're not quite as comfortable. And I would say after watching some film of a few games of them, definitely our advantage is if we can get ball to paint. If they run that zone against us, we've got a few good plays we've put in the last 2 to 3 weeks we've been running. And then some man plays if they go man to get it, you know, get it inside and use our size. Going to need to out-rebound them. Again, back to the conference thing, we did lead the conference in defensive rebounding, you know, and that's kind of our thing. We want to get stops and not give you extra looks. So hopefully we can do that against them tonight.
And Coach, like you referenced, getting inside and using your size advantage will certainly be a key to tonight's game. So what are a couple things you need to do to put your guys in position to take advantage of their size tonight?
Well, the thing with them, when they're pressing that ball, you know, up top or upside, it's something we've been talking about quite a bit. It's got to be a ball reversal instead of, you know, staring and looking inside or going right back to the wing we got it from. It's got to be you're hoping they're kind of trying to do a trap or something, you know, just accept that and get rid of it to the other side of the floor. And then our bigs can fill to that side with these plays we have. You know, we're kind of setting it up so we can get that ball reversal. And then it's either a high-low or a one-on-one. And if they can't rotate that well enough, or, you know, a guard has to go in the paint against our big guys, you know, it shouldn't end well for them, I would hope, with the size we have compared to their size.
Now, Coach, one of the other things you referenced was good athletic guard play out of GTRA. So defensively, what are a couple things you guys are going to be doing to counter that?
Well, number one, we're going to have to mix and match what we're doing. We're going to have to listen, you know, and it might be a hard environment to hear if it's loud. We understand that, but make sure you're looking over the bench and making these adjustments. We really need to jam them up at the three-point line. I would rather see them a few dribbles and have to pull up from the mid-range. Obviously, we still talk about that pack line of no layups, but those three shooters they have, and I would particularly want to pay attention to. It should never be anything on a set shot, meaning if they catch and shoot or if they run to it and it's a catch and shoot, we don't want that. You better be tight enough to make them put it on the deck and make a play with it. Even if it's a long shot, I'd almost prefer them doing something with the ball instead of just getting comfortable, especially with, you know, they're in their gym, so that helps too.
Now, Coach, just to wrap up here, what's going to be the final thing you tell to your guys before they come out onto the floor for tonight's game?
You know, aggressiveness, no float passes out of the press. Try and limit turnovers as best we can. I'd rather see you hold it and get a count than you throw it and they get a steal for a layup. A count is a better option than that layup, and we've done that probably too much this year, giving up those looks. Too many points have been scored off of our offense, and sometimes that's the other team's best offense is our offense. So that's not a great statement to make, but I think if we can play that defense hard and be patient offensively and, you know, keep them under their scoring average, just a few points, you know, five points, I'd be happy. 8 points would be better. 10's obviously going to be tough with them. And we're kind of in our scoring range or a click better, we're right there. So obviously if we averaged, you know, losing those conference games by that tight margin we did and we had 21 turnovers a game, obviously you take two or three out of that, well, that's different. Every game looks a lot easier. And that's not that big of drastic change, I believe. So we do that, we rebound the way we've rebounded and get stops, and I think we've got a heck of a shot against this team. We like this matchup better than the matchup we could have got if we'd have gone with the Lake Mills side. So we feel pretty good about that.
No doubt about it. Well, Coach, thanks for the time today and good luck in tonight's game.
All right, thanks, Tyler.
That's Bishop Garrigan head coach Mark Meister as we take a quick timeout, and we'll return with more pregame coverage next on Hometown Radio KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio, brought to you by these sports boosters.
Dump It, they do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Neil Albert Electric, flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Kemco Tires, they're all you need to know about tires and service.
Billy Joe's Bar and Grill, burgers and steaks cooked to perfection along with chops, chicken, and seafood.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, Highway 18 West.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
Bring you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
A big bank can deliver the products you need and the convenience you expect. A small bank can make you feel like family. At Fidelity Bank and Trust, we don't think you should have to choose. Your hometown bankers have roots here. We understand the community and why you want to live here, because we live here too. We're big enough to deliver, yet small enough to care. Fidelity Bank and Trust, your hometown bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Your hometown Fidelity Bank and Trust, located in Bancroft, Iowa.
When you buy appliances locally, you're supporting your friends and neighbors. When you buy appliances locally, you're helping the local economy. When you buy appliances locally, they'll be serviced by someone you know and trust. Get exceptional service every time when you buy from North Iowa Appliance Center. For almost 45 years, they've been carrying Maytag, KitchenAid, Whirlpool, and Amana, the best appliances on the market today. Inventory is coming in weekly, so check out the store to see what they have in stock. North Iowa Appliance Center, where they sell the best and service the rest.
We get ready for postseason basketball action here on Hometown Radio KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream. I'm Tyler Lance alongside Beanie Bodie as tonight's matchup brings the home team, the 15-6 GTRA Titans, against the road team, the 6-15 Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. Beanie, I'll tell you what, after GTRA lost to Bishop Garrigan in the first round of the postseason last year, 58-43, brought pretty much their entire team back this year. They've been waiting a whole year to get this shot at Bishop Garrigan, and in spite of being the favorite in this game, I would say they're going to be hungry for the win against an improved Golden Bear team.
Well, of course they are, and they are the two seed in this district. So the much higher seed than the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. And they are playing in their home court, which is a beautiful court, I might add. You know, there's a wall on one end, and there's not a wall on the other end. And that is going to disrupt some shooting by the Bears, probably. But the Bears get to start off the game on the hoop with the wall behind it. And it sounds silly, but that makes a big difference. You talk to players, they get used to shooting in their own gym. But the GTR is going to have that home court advantage. They're the higher seed. But I'm looking at the pregame stats that you prepare so nicely, Tyler, and I see that they shoot a lot of three-pointers. And the old adage is, you live by the three, you might die by the three. So they're going to be dependent on these three-point shots going in tonight in their home court. And if they don't, Garrigan's going to have a puncher's chance to come out of this game with a win.
You're absolutely right, Beanie. GTRA takes 41% of their shots from three-point range. They're shooting them at just over 32%, so a very good mark. But like you said, a cold shooting night could really disrupt GTRA. On the other side of things, Bishop Garrigan can use some size here tonight. They have three players who are taller than GTRA's tallest player, that is. And the Golden Bears will certainly look to get the ball inside tonight. Jacob Lehrer, Logan Nemers, Drew Mahler, Drew Fogarty, for that matter, all will have a role to play.
Oh, that's a good point, Tyler. There could be a big night out of the bigs on the Bishop Garrigan team. But the question is, can they get that ball into them consistently? It's going to be hard to bring the ball up the floor against an athletic and quick GTRA guard core. You watch them warm up. They're quick. They're going to be tough. Jack Granjanet's going to have his work cut out for him as the lead ball handler for the Bishop Garrigan Bears. But if he can get that ball up the floor and they can break that press as a team, which they've gotten a lot better at throughout the season, if they can break any pressure that the Titans throw at them, they're going to convert a lot of easy buckets tonight, especially if they get it to their big. So this could be an interesting matchup. You know, it's the tournament. Throw out all the records, they always say. And so let's disregard the 6-15 and the 15-6 and just see if these two teams can match up pretty well tonight.
Absolutely. You know, Bishop Garrigan wanted to be on this side of the bracket. Everyone wanted to avoid Lake Mills in the early rounds. So Golden Bears get what they wanted. Can they capitalize tonight? It's Bishop Garrigan against GTRA coming up next on Hometown Radio KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
More sports boosters making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Iowa Lakes Community College. Your community, your college.
Farmers State Bank, proud to be part of our community for over 125 years with offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Erpelding Excavating, let them take care of your grading and excavating plus drainage needs.
Stroman Family Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, collision specialist, a total commitment to excellence.
Algona Livestock Auction, Highway 169 North, sales every Monday.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, with two sauces for all seasons.
All bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Signworks Inc. has solutions for your signage needs, as well as vehicle graphics in all sizes, from a logo on the window to wrapping your entire vehicle, whether it's a banner, magnetic, or building signage. Signworks Inc. strives to provide fast, friendly service. They also are a source for custom screen printing on garments. If they can't provide you with what you need, they will direct you to who can. They are your local resource for signage and screen printing using your ideas and their creativity. Signworks Inc., 1613 East Locust Street, Algona, 295-9544, or email info@signworksinc.com.
Don't let concerns about current events derail your long-term financial strategy. Hi, I'm Edward Jones Financial Advisor Brady Ross, and I'm here to help. We can work together to understand today's financial landscape and make sure you achieve your goals. While you can't control market volatility, you can control your financial future. Let's connect. Contact me, Brady Ross, at 515-295-7763. Together with Bruce Keith, Jerry Sadler, and Mackenzie Keith, we are your local Edward Jones Financial Advisors. Edward Jones, making sense of investing, member SIPC.
Just about basketball time here on Hometown Radio KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream. Lightning quick look at the starting lineups for Bishop Garrigan: Jack Granjanet, Grant Hoagland, Aiden Hovey, Jacob Lear, Andrew Fogarty. GTRA has Eric Heinrichs, Max Huff, Drew Schnell, Corey Huff, and Dalton Young. Lear is at midcourt for Bishop Garrigan. He taps it back to Brandon Jeanette, and we're underway from GTRA High School. Golden Bears wearing the road blacks with the yellow lettering, GTRA home whites. Down low to Aiden Hobie, loses it between the legs. Three players pile up, and that'll be an early jump ball.
Well, the initial jump of the game easily won by Lear, and then a jump created by the GTRA defense. That possession arrow is going to go back and forth a lot tonight, I feel.
Lear is going to have a 3 to 4 inch size advantage over anyone on the court at any time for GTRA. Corner pocket three, Drew Schnell, a little bit off, and Grand Jeanette rebounds. Three ball is going to be a big storyline here tonight for GTRA. They start 0-1.
Boy, zero hesitation. They didn't even try to run the offense. Just like, hey, I've got an open three, I'm shooting it.
Drew Schnell is number 4 in the Twin Lakes Conference in three-point percentage at 40.9% as Grand Jeanette penetrates, flips it up, rolls off, no. Lear had the rebound off his fingertips, but it was knocked out of bounds off of GTRA as it'll stay with the Golden Bears.
You know, as a Bear fan, I like that penetration there by Grand Jeanette, getting that ball to the hoop, because if you get that ball up there, chances are Garrigan's going to have a good advantage on the boards.
Hoagland looking, lobbing it into Grand Jeanette, who reaches back to catch it. Bishop Garrigan scoring just under 54 points a game. GTRA scoring, or allowing just under 57, that is, as Lear catches in the lane, puts it off the glass and scores it. Golden Bears draw first blood. I have a feeling we'll be seeing a lot of lobs inside to Jacob Lear tonight.
Yeah, he hopefully, young man, has a big night.
Up to the top of the key, Eric Heinrichs, the junior, goes over to the right to Max Huff. GTRA has the core of their team intact from last season's 58-43 postseason loss against Bishop Garrigan. Into the paint, Young turns around, flips it up, and swishes it.
That's a pretty jump shot. Now they're putting on some pressure.
Dalton Young, the only member of the starting lineup not averaging 10 points a game, but he still has 7.5 as Hobie gets to the foul line. Hobie inside Lear with size, banging it off the glass and scoring it.
Just no way they can defend that shot by Jacob Lear once that ball gets inside. We break the press, get it inside, well execution.
Heinrichs, left angle three, swirls out of the drain. Offensive rebound, though, for Corey Huff. He'll go back up to the left hand, no. Tipped away, third opportunity. Heinrichs forces it through contact and a foul.
It's either going to be on Lear or Fogarty. They were both right there putting the pressure on, but impressive rebounding there. This is going to be on Fogarty. But good rebounding there by both teams, but the Titans just really muscling their way in there.
GTRA is a 62% foul shooting team as Heinrichs buries that one. Score now 4-3. Bishop Garrigan up by one here early. Heinrichs, the junior, bends his knees. That one bounces off and Fogarty rebounds. It's four juniors, one senior for GTRA as Grand Jeanette heads towards the left, has the ball in the center, flips it left to Hoagland. 6 minutes on the clock as Hoagland looks, goes into the corner to Fogarty, tried to fire it into the lane to Lear, got knocked it away, pulling underneath Grand Jeanette, defense left him behind, and he lays it in.
Oh, great vision there by Aiden Hovey. Knew Jack Grand Jeanette was under the hoop. Grand Jeanette getting an easy layup inside. He usually has to work a lot harder for those.
Another free ball attempt. This one bounces off. Hovey rebounds, and GTRA's missed their first 3 3-pointers.
There it is, that 3-point shot, so crucial for this offense of the Titans.
Corey Huff couldn't get it to fall. Hovey angles towards the lane, gets sandwiched in between a double team, and he got fouled on the wrist, as they will get number 22, Corey Huff, on that foul, his first.
Well, it's been a couple quick whistles. That time, quick whistle against Bishop Garrigan. The other time, a quick call on Andrew Fogarty. That could play big into this game, because GTRA needs to be physical.
Into Hovey, stolen away by Schnell. Quick hands as Schnell runs the court, gets right to the glass, and he'll lay it in. 6-5, the Bishop Garrigan lead, and that's what GTRA wants to do. They want to steal it, and they want to run. They trap Grand Jeanette. He passes out of it. It's stolen. Huff flips it into play, and he'll find his man up the court. Huff lays it up, and he bounces it in.
Oh, the GTRA crowd, they've seen this. You can tell they love it. You can feel the energy building there. Garrigan's got to slow this thing back down and get it back under control.
7-6, GTRA with the lead, and Coach Meister will take a quick timeout. And I think that's all about not liking the way the team was handling the ball against pressure that time.
Yeah, you feel the crowd rise up with the energy and the team respond. You want to nip that right in the bud. You don't need to let them get on a big momentum swing this early in the game. Kind of stifle it. You're only down 1 point, but you can see Garrigan was up by 4 just a moment ago. How fast this Titan team can move up and down the floor with those quick guards. You know, some of the guards, this is our first time seeing them, they're a little banged up. One of the guards is wearing a wrist brace. Looks like he's got a wrist sprain he's had. Other one's wearing a giant knee brace. But still plenty of quickness on the floor.
So GTRA leads 7-6. Bishop Garrigan's been turning it over this year over 21.5 times per game, and that's something Coach Meister talked about a lot in the pregame. He said, hey, we lost a few games by single digits this year. If we take away 3 or 4 or 5 turnovers a game, those games might swing the other direction.
Yeah, both these teams have played a significant number of close games. GTRA has been in a lot of contests that were decided by less than 10 points, and Garrigan was trying to get Ryan Noonan in over the break, but he didn't sub in time. Now he'll go check in again. He'll get to come in at the next dead ball. That's what the confusion on the floor was. Just wait a little too long to check in.
So Golden Bears will have it here for their starting five. Huff steals it away from Grand Jeanette, rolls it up the court, underneath, Huff to Huff. Huff off the glass, and he scores. Actually, that was Drew Schnell finding Corey Huff, but in any case, it makes it 9-6 Titans.
Boy, that's just an athletic play by the guards, and here comes another one.
Another steal, knocked away by Drew Schnell, goes into the hands of Max Huff. Top of the key, flips it all the way into the corner. Drew Schnell, catch and fire three, that one's off the mark. Offensive rebound, though, Max Huff comes back outside. Dalton Young goes into the far corner. Drew Schnell will try a three, that one's off the rim, and Hovey boxes out everyone for the rebound.
Well, advantage Garrigan if they keep missing these three-pointers. It's a long four-quarter game. But if they keep launching misses, that's going to favor Garrigan if they can work the ball inside again.
Fogarty splits the trap, heads to the lane, and he's fouled. Titans 0-5 so far in this game on three-pointers.
And right there is a player in Andrew Fogarty that most teams do not have an answer for, and I don't think the Titans do either. He's a physical player. He can play hard inside. He also shoots the three-pointer very well. You know, we get Andrew Fogarty scoring the ball, get his momentum going. That'll be big for the Bears here.
Ryan Noonan comes in for Bishop Garrigan, replacing Grant Hoagland. Colin Hoffman in for GTRA. Noonan on the elbow, out to Hovey. Hovey bullets it into the lane to Lear. Off his hands, Grand Jeanette saves it into play, but gets it right to Heinrichs for GTRA. Heinrichs weaves into the front court, flips it over to Wright. Three ball Max Huff off the back of the iron. Lear runs into Huff, and that'll be a foul on the board, and they'll get Huff on that one.
Yeah, boy, these fouls racking up for the Titans here a little bit. No one in foul trouble, obviously, this early in the game. But the officials are calling it tight. Probably a good idea. You want this game to get physical and out of hand, and Coach Huff wants a timeout for GTRA.
So Coach Huff takes the timeout. It's a 30-second timeout. So with that, we'll go ahead and take a quick word here from the Iowa High School Athletic Association as GTRA leads Bishop Garrigan 9-6.
When you go home, you'll feel good about what you did. And, you know, you're doing it for the kids. If they don't have us, they don't have these games.
So there you go. Those of you watching on the YouTube stream got the announcement there from the Iowa High School Athletic Association. Grand Jeanette comes into the front court over to Noonan. 9-6 GTRA. Fogarty with it up top. Comes right to Hovey. Hovey works around the perimeter, stops the elbow, turns, looks inside to Lear, over his head and out of bounds. Turnover, Bishop Garrigan. They're having a little trouble the last few possessions getting it inside to Lear.
Well, good strategy by Garrigan out of that timeout. They have a nice set play, but Grettinger knew that ball was coming in, and they do a nice double team on Lear. You know, you might not be as tall as Jacob Lear, but if you've got the athleticism to jump up and knock that ball away, I guess it's the same advantage.
You know, even though Bishop Garrigan has a size advantage, GTR has been crashing the boards. Alley-oop to Huff, but he misses the little tap right at the rim. That would have brought the house down if he'd finished that one. Fogarty into the lane. Hovey bounce pass to Lear, slips behind the defense, and he lays it in.
Great pass by Hovey. That's the second great pass Hovey has had, finding his teammates for open buckets. Assists to baskets, so important, and Hovey's getting it done.
Jacob Lear, 6 of the 8 Bishop Garrigan points. Golden Bears this year averaging just under 35 rebounds a game as a baseline jumper is canned by Corey Huff. GTRA just under 26 rebounds a game, but so far tonight, they're trying to aggressively get some offensive boards and try to offset the Bishop Garrigan size. Grand Jeanette has it of 2:32 on the clock, 11-8 GTRA. Grand Jeanette looks inside, comes left to Fogarty. He'll rip the trigger on a three, misses long. Lear secures the board. Outside Grand Jeanette, step back corner three, and he cans it. 11-11.
Tell you what, Jack Grand Jeanette hit a huge three in their previous game, and that just gave him all the confidence in the world.
Golden Bears weathering the early storm. Huff hangs and floats and misses. Offensive board, though, works out to Heinrichs. Weaves into the lane. Lost the basketball. Fogarty falls down. He got tripped by Heinrichs, and that'll be a foul on GTRA.
Yeah, another quick pickup of a foul by Heinrichs there. He's the one wearing the big wrist brace. He's got a taped-up wrist pretty firmly there, playing through injury, that young man is. But, the Titans, they're going to pay for these fouls at the end of the game if they don't temper them a little bit.
Four fouls for GTRA, one for Bishop Garrigan. Right now, the Golden Bears have avoided what I think was their biggest fear, if you look at the Golden Bear fans, as Hovey comes up to the top to Granjanet. And that's that GTRA gets off to a big early start. They go up 10-0, crowd's going crazy, and you're out of it early as Lear bangs inside, misses right at the rim. So they've kept it close here early, weathered the early storm, and now both teams settling into the ballgame. Heinrichs comes down into the near corner, open three ball, Corey Huff, and he splashes it through. That'll break the 0-for-6 start to the game for GTRA on threes, and it's 14-11.
You know, the Titans aren't doing a organized press. Just put a little pressure on Jack Granjanet. He's doing a nice job so far.
Into Fogarty, puts it off the glass and scores it, 14-13.
Great basket creation by the Bishop Garrigan offense on that one, working that ball inside to Fogues.
When Bishop Garrigan's been able to get it inside cleanly, they've had a high rate of success tonight. It's just been getting in there clean that's been the tough part. Dished outside to Schnell, rotates it around Heinrichs. Another free ball. That one swirls out. Offensive board, though, and the follow by Dalton Young as he is fouled with 51 seconds left.
So far, I'm impressed with GTRA's rebounding. Boy, they have a never-say-die attitude. Even when they're outnumbered, they really get after that ball, and it's cost them a couple foul calls, but two rebounds in the last two possessions that I thought Garrigan had easy.
Foul shot is swished by Dalton Young. He's making 66% of his free throws, and he gives GTRA a two-point lead. Oops, as Young right now will miss that one. He's stuck at 3 points after that miss. Fogarty passes away from trouble to Granjanet. Rotation to Noonan. Oh, had the open three, but he bobbled the ball, so he couldn't get it off. Fogarty into the lane. Fogarty hooks around, goes off the glass, and ties it at 15.
Oh, he's getting going.
Fogarty came all the way across the lane, up to the top of the key to Young. Young to the foul line now, sidearms it to Schnell. He'll hit the three-pointer. 18-15, GTRA has hit back-to-back threes on their last two attempts. Granjanet now comes across the Titan logo at midcourt of 12 seconds. Corner to Jacob Lear. Lear will try a three-pointer, and he'll swish it.
Oh, the big answer by Jacob Lear.
He'll tie it at 18. Garrigan fans who made the trip love it. Three-pointer at the buzzer, and that's an air ball from Huff. What a high-flying first quarter. 18-18 ties. We go to the second right here on Hometown Radio, KLGA.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio, brought to you by these sports boosters.
Daylight Donuts, open early, serving yummy donuts, rolls, and great coffee. Located at 502 South Phillips Street.
Farm and Home Services. Check their many listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona. Create yourself.
Holmes Animal Clinic, caring for your pets, and they have an indoor unit to serve equine, cattle, sheep, and goats, plus on-site boarding for cats and dogs.
Farm Bureau Financial Services, agents Dave Beisch, Michael Toll, Jason Brace, and Daniel Foth.
Dance Connection by Michelle, passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
The Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service. Call 295-SOFT.
Rental Zone, Highway 18 East Algona, the tool and equipment rental specialist. Phone 395-RENT.
All sponsors of this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Second quarter here from GTRA High School, where right now it is an 18-18 tie. The visiting Bishop Garrigan hit a three-pointer of Jacob Lear right before the horn to tie this game up. Jacob Lear with 9 points leading the way for the Golden Bears as Hoagland bullets it to Hovey, dumps it inside. Lear catches, hesitates, puts it up, counted in the foul. Jacob Lear drew Heinrichs up in the air, and he finished for a chance at a three-point play.
Great execution there. Every time they get that ball to Aiden Hovey or whoever's playing the high post spot, they know right away, immediately pass that ball to Jacob Lear. He's going to have the size advantage and easy pickings for the big man. Nice play by the Bears coming out of the quarter break.
So Lear already with 11 points. Will shoot the free throw here, and he drains it. Muir has greatly improved his foul shooting throughout the season, and now he's gotten really quite reliable at the line. Huff in the center of the court right now as Bishop Garrigan leads GTRA by three. With it is Patrick Fiddler, who just checked into the ball game for the first time tonight. Heinrichs in the lane, hangs, floats, and scores.
Boy, this GTR team, just good shooting. Good shooting team. Boy, they make the easy ones, and of course, they're heating up from three-point land.
So 21-20, they trap Fogarty, passes around the trap. Hobie to the baseline, Lear. Lear leans back, works outside Fogarty. He'll rip the trigger on a three. It's a little long. Lear tips it to himself. Lear got his pocket picked, though, and Max Huff steals it away. Huff up the near side of the court, and he'll stop, and Fogarty will bump him from behind. Boy, smart play that time by Huff.
That was. Huff tried to pick up Fogarty on a foul right after he stole the ball, and Fogarty tried to steal. Didn't get that call, and I think he could just sense that Andrew Fogarty was going to be overly aggressive here. Very smart play by that young man.
So Fogarty picks up his second foul of the game. Five team fouls on GTRA, three on Bishop Garrigan. Huff, number one in the Twin Lakes in assists, comes over to Drew Schnell. Now back to the right to Huff. Huff will fire it off the foot of Grandjeanette and out of bounds.
Grandjeanette always willing to sacrifice his body. Hitting the floor all the time, hitting walls. That time puts his leg out in front of the pass. You know, they have not recognized Fogarty as a three-point shooter. He's going to keep getting open looks, I think. But if he starts draining those, Garrigan's going to be really tough down the stretch.
Fiddler will get an open look from three. He's off the back of the rim, and Grandjeanette and Hovey will combine for the rebound. Into the front court comes Fogarty, now left to Grandjeanette. Up top as he surveys the defense. Hoagland spins away from trouble, right into a three-pointer. Rattles off, pops loose in the lane, and it's picked up by Huff.
Oh, that was a great look in rhythm by Grant Hoagland. I thought it was halfway down, popped right out.
Schnell up to the top to Corey Huff. He penetrates, steps right past Jacob Lear, puts it in, and he got fouled. What a move that time by Corey Huff. Just went right around the big man.
Yeah, boy, that's confidence. That's just a lot of experience. Like you said, Tyler, these guys are all back from last season. They lost to Garrigan in the tournament last year. Whether they remember that or not, who knows? But, boy, they are playing with ferocity every time they go in that lane tonight.
Huff drains it, and that's a three-point play. Corey Huff's been averaging about 10 points per game. You know, in last year's matchup, GTRA went 4 of 30 on three-pointers, and that is what Bishop Garrigan is hoping to replicate tonight because they know GTRA may shoot 30 three-pointers in this game. Inside Lear as he gets banged by Fiddler that time, and that'll be a foul.
Yeah, boy, the strategy, they're fronting Jacob Lear, and they're bringing backside help, but right now that backside help just isn't enough. Garrigan can still lob that ball into Lear, so if that young man can keep being big inside, he's going to get a lot of trips to the free throw line and a lot of points throughout this evening.
Grandjeanette from the baseline. GTRA already has six fouls here. As Fogarty comes to Hobie, turns to face the bucket, goes 360, outside Fogarty again, far side of the court, inside Lear, working in the post, goes off the glass, it's long. Hobie has it knocked out of his hands, but it's right to Grandjeanette for an offensive board. 5:40 to go. Grandjeanette flips it over to the left to Hoagland around the perimeter. Hoagland guarded by Max Huff. Inside Fogarty of space. Got swatted at, and that'll be a foul on Drew Schnell as he tried to tomahawk the ball.
Well, that was a great look inside. Bringing Lear out to the perimeter. He just hit a three-pointer the second ago, so that now they know they got to guard Lear out on that three-point line, and that makes Fogarty open down low, and he's a matchup problem down there. Very good to the basket.
Drew Muller into the game as Aiden Hovey heads to the bench. And Fogarty will shoot the one and one here for Bishop Garrigan. And he's perfect on the first one, making it 23-22.
So with Muller coming off the bench into the game, Garrigan has got a huge size advantage right now. Jack Grandjeanette is the only player for the Bears that isn't taller than every one of the other Titans.
Second foul shot missed. Score stays 23-22. Bounce pass down low. Knocked away. Picked back up, though, by Young. Dishes it outside to Heinrichs. Left angle triple is long. Offensive board, though, for Huff. And it's taken away by Grandjeanette. Golden Bears come up with a steal. Up the court, Mahler. Mahler lost the basketball out of his hands as he went up a bit. Just slipped out of his hands there, out of bounds.
Oh, coming off the bench, sometimes that happens. You come off the bench, you're a little cold, and the first thing that happens to you is you're caught in a fast break. Too bad he couldn't have had a little bit more warm-up time. But great play by Jack Grandjeanette to even create that, picking up a steal, getting the run-out possibility.
That's why assists are such a tough stat, because Grandjeanette made a great pass there too, but you can make the best pass in the world and if the shot's not made, yeah. No assist. Heinrichs goes over onto the right wing to Huff. Down onto the block, Dalton Young. Dalton Young against Lehrer. Lehrer towers over him, and he'll work it back outside. Corey Huff into the lane, gives it to Heinrichs. He'll float it up, no. Pops loose to the strong side where it's picked up by Hoagland.
Nice board by Hoagland.
Grandjeanette up the court, gives to Fogarty. He'll pump fake inside. He'll go all the way across to Lehrer. Lehrer off the glass, no. Tipped by Mahler, back out, and it's picked up by Drew Schnell for GTRA. Schnell comes on to the wing to Huff. He'll try three, and he banks it in as he shrugs and heads back up the other end of the court.
I guess he'll take what he can get off that bank, but he clearly did not try to that one. He gives a little chuckle as he heads back down.
Drew Mahler gets run into as Huff almost undercut him that time. And again, with the bonus, this is where you shoot one and one, and this is what Bishop Garrigan can take advantage of.
Absolutely. They can shoot free throws for the next 4 minutes until halftime, so keep playing physical. The Titans want to foul you. I knew it was going to come back to haunt them a little bit, and they're trying to put more pressure on the full court. That's going to lead to more foul calls. So coaches on the coaching staff for GTRA has to make the decision. They want to keep pressing this whole 4 minutes because it could turn into a lot of free throws, and Drew Mahler at the line, an excellent free throw shooter.
Logan Nemers comes in for Jacob Lehrer as Mahler will drain that one. So you may be losing a little bit of athleticism there, but you're adding a little more raw power, which will be interesting to see how that plays against a smaller GTRA team.
Right, Nemers is good down low. He's got some footwork.
And Mahler splashes the foul shot through, making it 26-24. Titans still up by two. 4:07 to go to the near side of the court with the basketball for the Titans. It's Casey Huff inside, knocked away, and it's picked up by Hovey. DeGrangenet right underneath the bucket as he comes up the center of the court. GTRA drops back on defense. Grandjeanette crosses over, top of the key, Mahler. They left him open. He'll try three, but it's off to the right. Nemers reaches above everyone. He follows. He misses. Mahler tips it. It's loose on the court, and a jump ball will be called here.
Well, Nemers off the bench playing sharp. He just created a turnover on one end. And that time, he does a great job getting the rebound, keeping the ball up high, going right back up with it like you train him. Nice job by Nemers, but that's going to be a jump ball goes back over. Now, you know, this next 3.5 minutes for GTRA, they're going to have to come up with a bit of a strategy against this bigger team, the Bishop Garrigan Bears.
They'll try to shoot from outside. Three ball misses off to the right, and Grandjeanette skies for the rebound. Grandjeanette to the near side, Hoagland fought about catching and firing, but he'll hold it here instead and go back to Grandjeanette. Grandjeanette to the left wing, Mahler. Mahler dribbles towards the right around the perimeter. He's looking inside, he's turning, he's falling back, avoided the travel there as he got it away to Grandjeanette. Grandjeanette left to Hoagland. Hoagland will try a deep three-pointer. That one bounces high off the rim, and Schnell secures the rebound.
Both teams settling for three-pointers. Not the strategy that either of them want.
Schnell goes to the far side of the court, into the lane, Young, and he'll get fouled. Dalton Young attacks the basket that time, and he will shoot two here.
So GTRA wants to shoot three-pointers, but they shoot these three-pointers much better when they come off of plays like that. That's a good take to the hoop, and you can always get the kick-out three-pointer. Same thing for the Bears. Like, these teams can kind of get three-pointers whenever they want.
That foul shot rattles around and pops out, and you're right, Bishop Garrigan basically has to respect the drive from GTRA if they keep driving it in like that. They can't just sit on the three-pointer all night.
Yeah, first try to create something better. You can always get that three-point shot.
And that foul shot is drained here by Young. 27-24 GTRA. Grandjeanette will be fouled as they try to trap him in the corner. And again, 1-1 coming up.
Yeah, and in this situation, you just have to recognize that if you're the Titans. Like, that's another foul picked up. It doesn't matter if the crowd likes it or not. Like, the officials have been calling it tight the whole time. So, they've got to really recognize that. You know, if the umpire's calling the outside strike, you got to swing at that outside strike.
I like the baseball analogy as Grandjeanette makes the foul shot. It's 27-25 right now.
I knew you would, Tyler. That baseball season's going to be here all too quickly for you to be calling those balls and strikes from behind the fence.
Oh, it will come very quickly here. It's hard to believe we're in postseason basketball right now as we speak, as Grandjeanette goes 2-for-2, and it's 27-26 tight.
Hey, those are huge free throws by Grandjeanette. He doesn't get to the line all that often. He ices those two free throws. Big advantage.
Now a mid-range jumper on the way, rolls off the rim. Schnell missed, and Mahler will try to split the gap. Oh, but he stepped out of bounds.
Oh, I thought they were going to get another foul. I thought someone got a hand on Drew Mahler. He steps out of crowd. The student section for GTRA is right there. There's no wall where you think a wall would be. There's just a wall of students.
They may have encouraged the call as Young will swish a jumper from the lane, and GTRA back up by three.
Well, looking forward to the second half. That's going to be a challenge for the Bishop Garrigan to shoot in front of that student section.
Mahler passes it left. Max Huff jumps it. Goes to the bucket. He'll rise and he'll lay it in. 31-26. That's what Bishop Garrigan avoided most of the second quarter. But that turnover turned into an easy layup.
Yeah, they're not scoring on the three-point shots. They're just creating other ways.
Hobie down low, Weirer. He puts it up. It bounces off the rim, though, off of Mahler's fingers and into the hands of Schnell. Missed opportunity for the Golden Bears. Here comes Huff, stopping for a mid-range J, and he swishes it. 33-26, timeout, Coach Meister. And with that timeout, we'll go ahead and we will look for another quick word here from the Iowa High School Athletic Association as it's 33-26 GTRA.
Good, good. Good sportsmanship is also showing high character and accountability, doing what is right and setting a good example, not only on the court, but in the classroom as well.
As we come back here on the YouTube stream and on Hometown Radio KLGA, it's GTRA 33, Bishop Garrigan 26. Golden Bears have gotten a little loose with the basketball here the past couple possessions as the Titans have turned up the defensive pressure.
Offensively, something good has happened. Every time they've gotten Aiden Hovey the ball, he's been able to find Jacob Lear down low for good looks. You know, that offense is working. They just haven't got the baskets to fall lately. And as you said a moment ago, Tyler, can't have those turnovers for open layups by the Titans.
Golden Bears with the basketball. Hovey on the left side, beyond the perimeter, turns all the way around, tried to fire it inside the Lear, over his head. Hoagland shovels it into play, but he threw it off of Fogarty's hip, where it deflects back into the bench of GTRA.
All right, big minute and a half here for both teams. Garrigan needs to come up with a big defensive stop here. Don't let any three-pointers get fired up. Get that rebound, go back and put up, get a couple points on the board before halftime in this last minute.
Oh, and a foul here against GTRA. It happened away from the play as Huff was just dribbling there on the wing, and they will get number 20, Drew Schnell, on that one. His third.
Yeah, boy, big foul. That's his third foul before halftime here. He's going to have to take a seat the rest of the way. He's been that one that's creating havoc in the press. He's everywhere, and that is a big foul call. Once again, got to recognize those ticky-tack calls are happening.
And that's GTRA's leading scorer on the season at 15.5 points a game as Hobie powers inside. Heinrichs stays vertical and disrupts the shot. Up to Max Huff. 106 on the clock. Back to the top to Heinrichs. Hoagland pokes it in. Heinrichs goes right around and scoops the layup up and misses. And a whistle and a foul here on Grand Jeanette.
No, Grand Jeanette.
I believe I saw number two up. Oh, maybe okay. It was 2-4.
Yeah, that was on the backside of the rebound.
It
wasn't
Grand
anywhere
Jeanette.
Near the ball. He was just maybe got caught for a push, getting in position for the rebound, but the officials are right on it. They're going to keep this game clean.
First foul shot is up, and that is drained by Heinrichs, who's averaging just over 12.5 points per game so far tonight with four. Heinrichs again, and he drains it. You know, it's a credit to the Titans that Bishop Garrigan's been in the bonus here for over 5 minutes, and the Titans have actually extended their lead as Grand Jeanette tried to wedge it between two players, but he falls down and loses it. Up the court comes Young, top of the key, Max Huff, goes around Grand Jeanette, stops for an elbow jumper, air balls, Hobie rebounds.
Good heads-up play by Hobie. Now Bears got to convert right here.
42 seconds to go. Corner to Hoagland. This could really shape how Bishop Garrigan feels about themselves going into the second half. Grand Jeanette crossing over across the foul line, comes to Fogarty, right angle triple, and that one is long, but rebounded by Grand Jeanette with 29 seconds.
Another good look by Fogarty, just not falling yet. He'll keep shooting. He'll get those in.
Lehrer in the corner, holds above his head, comes to the wing to Hoagland, passes up the three and comes up top to Fogarty. 15 seconds to go, Grand Jeanette far side of the court. Now Hovey, one step inside the three-point line, inside Lehrer, behind the defense, and he lays it in. Now 7 seconds to go, 35-28 Titans, quickly up the court. Here comes Hoffman, now back up to the top, sidestepping is Huff for a jumper at the buzzer, but it's off target, and that will be halftime. Well, the Golden Bears gave up a little bit of ground there in the second quarter, but a bucket right before the break makes it 35-28 as we go to halftime. We'll get a couple quick words here from our sponsors, and we'll come back with some stats and analysis next on Hometown Radio, KLGA.
More sports boosters bringing you this tournament broadcast.
Vasky Sales and Service of Bancroft, Hustler and Snapper Lawnmowers, and Complete Automotive Repair.
Security State Bank in Algona, Burt and Laverne, your partners in community banking.
Helmer's Insurance Agency, get your insurance quote today.
Jumbo's Liquor in Wesley.
Al Lobid Marine of Wesley, Aluma Craft Boats and Mercury Outboards.
Windsor Manor, excellence in senior living every day.
Steyr Ag Aviation, aerial and ground application, agronomy services.
Marceau's Golden Harvest Seed Sales, Jim Marceau.
The Market, be happy, shop the market.
All bringing you this broadcast on Hometown Home Country Radio.
At Wiffles Hybrids, they're completely focused on developing and producing the very best seed corn on the planet. It's an act they've been polishing for more than 70 years, right here in the heart of the Corn Belt. Wiffles Hybrid, one thing done right. For more information, contact Rich Rosenmeyer, Dale Lappy, or Mitchell Carroll at JDR Seed of Wesley, 515-341-2452, or visit wiffles.com.
Kemna Quick Lane is the easy, fast, and convenient way to get an oil change.
No appointment needed, just show up.
Oil changes start at $59.95 for the 6-quart basic package, including inspection, fluid top off, air and cabin filter check. They can also rotate your tires and replace your air filter or cabin filter for additional charges.
The Quick Lane is open 7:30 to 5 Monday through Friday and 7:30 to noon on Saturdays. Don't stress when your vehicle says change the oil now. Just drive to Kemna Quick Lane, Highway 18 West, Algona.
No appointment needed.
Kemna cares.
High school tournament sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio. Brought to you by these sports boosters.
Algona Dairy Queen. Their new season is underway, now open 11 to 9 daily.
Algona Floor Design. Your local flooring specialist since 1978.
Dietering Brothers in Bancroft. Farm equipment, sales, and service.
Goshi Custom Cabinets. They'll meet all your kitchen, countertop, and cabinet needs.
Seven Sweets. A day without sweets is a day wasted.
Tegas Chiropractic. Your freedom of pain is in their hands.
North Iowa Cleaning Solutions in Britt, making your vehicle shine from the inside out.
Trend Salon. Your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Rothler Electric. Don't be left in the dark. Call 295-7117 today.
I'll bring you this game on the radio.
We are back here at halftime on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream, brought to you by Kemna Auto, where it's not just about the car, it's about the care. Algona State Farm Insurance Agent Billy Offerman. Algona Municipal Utilities, where they're community-owned for community benefit, and families of Bishop Garrigan High School, all streaming sponsors of our broadcast on the YouTube page. Also, thank you to Greg Penning & Company, Certified Public Accountants. They are the scoreboard sponsor, as right now the scoreboard reads GTRA 35, Bishop Garrigan 28, as it was the Titans with a nice edge there in the second quarter, 17-10 over the Golden Bears, turning that 18-18 tie into the margin we have right now. But I'll tell you what, Beanie, Bishop Garrigan, they're hanging tough in this one. You can tell they're a little bit out athletic, for a lack of a better term, by GTRA, but they've been trying to get the ball inside. It's just a few turnovers have plagued them, and they weren't quite able to extend the lead of the bonus as they wanted to.
Yes, you take away a couple turnovers that led to layups, and this game is probably knotted up around 28. That was a great bucket at the end of the first half to give Garrigan some momentum. They've got plenty of confidence in that locker room right now that they can score inside. They've gotten the ball to Aiden Hovey in the middle of the free throw lane, and he's been finding Jacob Lear down low. Fogarty's had open threes that didn't go in. If they start going in, you know, the coach has got to be encouraging them, hey, they're right in this game against a team that's seeded much higher than them. So, I mean, they're the underdogs. They got nothing to lose. They should come out and play a really confident second half, just trying to pick off the GTRA Titans. The Titans, on the other hand, boy, they've shown the ability to score in a hurry. They can put up points in very limited time. But that means they can also go on a little bit of a drought. So if they go on a little bit of a drought, Garrigan gets right back in this game. In these tournament games, the fourth quarters get to be intense. You know, you put a little pressure on the home team, that could be an advantage, Garrigan. They just got to stay in this game and keep it close.
And on the other side of things, if I'm in the locker room right now and I'm the Titans, I'm saying, hey, we shot 3 of 14 in the first half on three-pointers. That's below what we normally do. We missed a lot of three-pointers to start the game, and we're still up by 7 here. So if we start shooting a little bit better in the second half, we can take care of this game. So Golden Bears will try to keep the Titans relatively cold here on the three-point ball. And again, like you said, Beanie, I think it all comes down to taking care of the basketball, because that was the inconsistent part for Bishop Garrigan in half number one. They would go a few minutes where they were taking great care of the ball.
Yeah.
They were getting inside the leer. They were shooting some open threes, and then they'd go a couple minutes where they would turn it over every other possession.
Right, and at this end of the season situation, you know, they know who they are. You know you're going to turn the ball over a few times. It's how you react and respond to that. Like after Grettinger, they're good guards. They're going to get some steals. After that happens, does your team bounce right back and then get back down the floor and make something positive happen? You just don't want one negative to lead to another negative, and pretty soon there's a big run for the Titans on the floor. But another thing that's going to play a lot into this second half, I think, is we're going to switch ends now on the floor, and it's going to be a little bit daunting for the Garrigan players. They're going to be now shooting at a basket that doesn't have a wall behind it. It is open up into the cafeteria for the school, and the student section for the Titans is right behind the hoop. They're all dressed up in their Valentine's gear since it's Valentine's Day. They look great down there, but it's going to be a challenge for the Bishop Garrigan offense to shoot with that that student section right in their faces and a hoop that looks a little different than what they're used to. I think that's going to – I'm really curious to see how that plays out. You know, another thing, Tyler, if you're the Titans, your game is transition, speed. Get the guards going. Get the momentum going in your favor. But they took themselves completely out of it with all that foul trouble. Like,
yes.
If you're in the locker room right now, you got to be thinking, hey, guys, why are we committing so many fouls? You know, they've got their best scorer, already has three fouls. That could be big if he picks up any more. But, you know, they are basically they're shooting themselves in the foot of their own game plan here. So I think Garrigan, they might be down here by 7 points, but I think they're sitting in a pretty good position to get back in this game if they come out and play a sharp third quarter.
You know, that really is a hidden aspect of this upcoming second half, because you're right. GTRA picked up a lot of fouls in the first half, and even, you know, starters of two fouls instead of three. One of them does that three, as you mentioned, with right now Drew Schnell having the three fouls. But Golden Bears don't have to think of it like, oh, we need to get seven fouls now and get in the bonus. It's no, you know, we draw one or two here, you know, maybe get Schnell's fourth foul, give the other starters maybe their third, and all of a sudden GTRA is going to a bench that has not been particularly deep.
Yeah, make them go to their bench, and Garrigan can do that by just keep getting the ball into that inside area. Get the ball to Fogarty down low. Get the ball to Lear down low. Logan Nemers down low. They will commit those fouls. They have to, because they're outsized. And if they don't play aggressive, and if they don't play aggressive, Garrigan will score easily. And if you play aggressive, you're going to pick up a few fouls. That's just the way the game is. So Garrigan, just stick to that plan. Keep pounding it inside. See if you can create some points and some foul trouble for the Titans.
So that's where it stands at halftime. Right now, GTRA leading Bishop Garrigan 35-28. We'll take a quick timeout and come back for the second half next on Hometown Radio KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
Get ahead of the game and schedule your students' back-to-school appointments with Kossuth Regional Health Center. We're all hoping for a healthy start to the school year. Call the Care HC Clinic in Algona or Bancroft to schedule well child visits, immunizations for kindergarten and middle school students, and wellness exams for student athletes. Don't wait until the last minute. Get ahead of the game and call Kossuth Regional Health Center at 515-295-2451 or visit krhc.com.
Your home for health care.
More Sports Boosters bringing you this tournament broadcast.
Dean Meyer Electric. They'll help you look to a bright future.
Fairway Meat and Grocery. Everything's easier, fresher, and faster with your Algona Fairway.
Algona Manor Care Center. Your home away from home with quality care.
Mansky Farm Drainage. Providing top quality professional service to the area since 1969.
Birch Plumbing and Heating. Here for you anytime, day or night.
Algona Municipal Utilities, community-owned for community benefit.
North Iowa Lumber and Design. You've got a lot more going for you with Hank, Hardware Hank.
Schindler Lawn Care and Landscaping. Contact them at 515-320-3840 or schindlerlawncare@gmail.com.
Premier Pizza, located in downtown Algona.
All bringing you this tournament broadcast.
It's just about time for the second half as GTRA leads Bishop Garrigan 35-28 in this Class 1A first-round game. I'm Tyler Lance. My partner is Beanie Bodie, and should be an interesting second half. We broke it all down for you at halftime as the Golden Bears get ready to come out and try to make a little push here and get back into this one down by 7. But again, manageable. You weathered the early storm on the road in front of a hostile environment, and you're still close here in the second half.
Yeah, you're in this game. You just got to come out and play sharp. You know, it means absolutely nothing but both teams look like they're a little stressed coming out of halftime. Neither team is making anything in their warm-ups. Both ice cold and warm-ups. Of course, it means nothing. Garrigan gets to start with the ball here. They always have a nice little play drawn up out of halftime. Usually they go for maybe that backdoor look, or maybe they're going to go for that look to Hovey in the lane. But they've got it all set up now. Now they just got to execute it. Here we go.
Jacob Lehrer with 14 points to lead the Golden Bears. Corey Huff, 15 to lead GTRA. Lehrer is out on the perimeter, comes up top to Grandjeanette. Grandjeanette looks, comes back to the far side. Fogarty to Hovey just outside the lane. Tries to dump it inside. Lehrer reaches out to catch it. Goes to the bucket hard, misses. Gets his own rebound. Hooks it back up and puts it in.
Well, that play has been bread and butter all night. Get it to Hovey at the free throw line or free throw line extended, and he knows right where Jacob Lehrer is.
35-30, Bishop Garrigan down by five here to GTRA. To the near side of the court for the Titans with the basketball. It's Max Huff, turns to face the bucket, shovels it into the lane to Corey Huff. Now back outside Max Huff. Started to drive in, backed it up, bounced it into the corner to Heinrichs. Now a turnaround jumper from mid-range, rattles out of the drain for Young. Offensive board, Max Huff, he puts it in, and he got fouled. He put some wicked spin on that one, and he'll try to finish a three-point play.
Oh, that was going to be such a big swing. Garrigan scores on a nice play coming out of half. It rattles in and out. It looks like Garrigan's going to come away with a good defensive stop, but Huff somehow gets that rebound and creates the and-one situation and nails the free throw to boot.
And you talk about foul trouble. Drew Fogarty now has three fouls for Bishop Garrigan. That could be an issue here in the second half. Hoagland bounces it down onto the block to Hovey, and Max Huff takes it right out of his hand. Hovey held that ball a little bit out wide that time as it's up the court to Drew Schnell. Schnell bullets it around the perimeter. Now a three-ball attempt on the way from Dalton Young, and he hits it. Titans have their largest lead of the night, 41-30.
Oh, they weren't making anything in warm-ups, and Dalton Young just steps up and swishes that three-point shot.
Young, a 30% three-point shooter this season, hits one there. 6:51 on the clock. Grandjeanette over to Fogarty. He'll try a left angle triple off the back of the iron. Long rebound tipped into Huff's hands. Ready-made run for Huff. Bounce pass into the lane. Knocked away, though, as he couldn't find Schnell that time. Up the court, Lehrer leaks behind the defense and lays it in.
Oh, great bucket. Great to run the floor by Jacob Lehrer. Showing some speed in the open floor. Way to create by Jack Grandjeanette. Now Max Huff with the ball. He's been big so far this third quarter. Boy, playing smooth, the upperclassman.
Max Huff, number one in the Twin Lakes in steals, and now he'll dish it to the baseline, cut to Corey Huff, who lays it in. Max Huff's also number one in assists, as you saw right there.
Oh, that was a pretty pass. Yeah, Max Huff just really playing well so far this third quarter. It's just beginning.
Hovey at the elbow, into the corner, Lehrer. He tries another three, and he swishes it again.
I don't have to see the stats. Jacob Lear's got to be the best shooting three-point shooter on the Bishop Garrigan Bears.
Let him shoot it, Coach Meister. 43-35 to the baseline, and now a blocking foul against Bishop Garrigan.
The first three-pointer Jacob Lehrer made was at Four City, a huge one. It led to the Bears winning down at Four City, and everyone was surprised. And ever since then, he's just been stroking them from the three-point line.
That is a new element to the offense as Heinrichs tries a corner pocket three, left it short as Grandjeanette skies for the rebound. And now a foul against GTRA, which will be their first here of the half. And they will get it on number 22 there. Corey Huff picking up his third foul as well. So
yeah.
Now three key players of three fouls if you combine the teams.
Absolutely. It's mounting, and that was another silly foul. Jack Grandjeanette skied for that rebound, came down with it, had control. Just a pointless hack on Jack Grandjeanette, and that's going to create some problems here. Bears are behind, but they're going to come back in this.
Hovey on the baseline, no room to work, bounces it back into the near corner to Fogarty. Tried to throw it up top, Grandjeanette knocked away by Corey Huff. Huff runs right of the lane, long strides to the bucket, tried to float it and missed, but he followed his own miss and he put it in.
Well, that was athletic play there by Huff. Just hang time in the air, didn't have to come down on the rebound.
19 points for Huff, back up to a 10-point game. Grandjeanette squeezes between the defense, but he falls down and loses the ball, but it pops right back into Lear's hands. Stripped by Max Huff and taken by Heinrichs. And now a foul on Lear as Heinrichs spills to the deck.
Oh, Jacob Lehrer made a great recovery. He got that ball back for the Bears by being in the right place at the right time and a good hustle. And then, boy, the Garrigan crowd definitely thought Jacob Lehrer got fouled on that shot. No call, and he's frustrated, commits a foul. You hate to see that happen. It happens so often. A frustrated player commits a foul right after the grievance towards him.
With that, we'll step aside here for a quick timeout. It's GTRA 45, Bishop Garrigan 35.
Don't let concerns about current events derail your long-term financial strategy. Hi, I'm Edward Jones financial advisor Brady Ross, and I'm here to help. We can work together to understand today's financial landscape and make sure you achieve your goals. While you can't control market volatility, you can control your financial future. Let's connect. Contact me, Brady Ross, at 515-295-7763. Together with Bruce Keith, Jerry Sadler, and Mackenzie Keith, we are your local Edward Jones financial advisors. Edward Jones, making sense of investing, member SIPC.
.507 on the clock in the third quarter as GTRA leads Bishop Garrigan 45-35. And Beanie, right now it feels like Bishop Garrigan is trying to climb up a slippery hill.
Yeah, but there's a lot of time left. 5 minutes here in the third quarter, plenty of time. Bears don't want to start panicking, don't squeeze. Just stick with the game plan. They can hack away at this 10-point lead as long as they don't panic.
They've gotten it close a couple times here in the second half. Passes bulleted into Mullane to Heinrichs. Kisses it off the glass and scores. Heinrichs had two players right in his face, but he got it anyways. 47-35. Fogarty sees Huff, passes to Grandjeanette. As Grandjeanette comes across the timeline up the near side of the court, weaves towards the near far side, that is, over to Lehrer. Lehrer looks, comes back towards the left to Fogarty. Foul line Hovey. Hovey turns. He'll dive to the bucket. He'll try to squeeze between two players, and that was a bad idea as Heinrichs takes it away. Outlets to Schnell, and he'll get the easy layup.
Well, that is some impressive speed up the floor, so fast up the floor, the guards for GTRA.
They are always looking to run. Hoagland goes to Hovey at the foul line. Hovey to a cutting Fogarty, takes one dribble, powers it up, rolls off, no. Lehrer the rebound, and Lehrer will be fouled. Boy, Huff that time got his hand in between the ball and Lear's face, and it really created an odd situation to cause the foul.
Yeah, it was an odd situation. Lear just had to twist and turn his body to create that foul. You know, there's been a physical contact down here on the offensive end for the Bishop Garrigan Bears. They're playing through contact. Not getting called as tight here this third quarter.
That was Huff's fourth foul, so he'll head to the bench with 19 points. That was probably the last guy they wanted to pick that up as Garrigan tries to get spaced out. Lehrer to the baseline, turning, sees a double team, backs up into the corner. Now they're really respecting the three-pointer.
Yeah, they're not letting him have a three-pointer that time.
Grandjeanette goes over to Hoagland, far side of the court. 3:47 on the clock. Grandjeanette gets it back. Comes to the near side to Noonan, into the lane, Fogarty. He got blocked, but he got fouled as well.
There we go. Another foul picked up. They keep pounding that ball inside. Granger Terrell, Ruth Van Ayrshir is going to keep fouling, and they're going to mount up. They've already got one guy on the bench with four fouls, and they're still 3:40 to go in the third quarter.
And that foul goes against Patrick Fiddler, his second, as the free throw rolls off to the left for Fogarty. No good.
Now Fogarty needs to sink this free throw, not just because we need the point, but because it'll get him in rhythm. Sometimes a free throw is a great way to kickstart your shooting, and there he goes, knocks it down. Maybe that'll get his three-point basket falling, which the Bears could really use here the rest of this game.
49-36, GTRA up. They've only taken two threes here in the second half. They've missed both as Heinrichs looks. He'll stop for a mid-range jumper. That one is way long. Lehrer sprints and grabs that long rebound, kicking all the way to the near side of the court by the scoring table. Grandjeanette handles it up top for the Golden Bears. The junior stops his dribble, comes over to the right wing to Hoagland. Down onto the block, Fogarty backing his way in, powering it up and scoring it.
There we go, mismatch. They can't foul every time. That time, easy conversion for the Deuce.
8 points for Fogarty. Out on the wing, it's Fiddler. He'll pass it over to the right to Schnell. Into the far corner of the court to Huff. Across the foul line, driving, getting to the bucket, and laying it in. Nice job that time, Dalton Young. He has 11 points. He won off the dribble that time, making it 51-38. 2:40 on the clock. Grandjeanette to Fogarty, grabs the ball with one hand and flips it back to the right. Grandjeanette around the way goes to Noonan. Noonan all the way across to Hoagland. Down into the post again to Fogarty. He'll bang inside again. He'll put it up. He got fouled and he scored it.
Oh, that's a great job by Fogarty. Arms all over him. He just powers up and through, maintains control of the ball. Boy, the Titans are not letting the Bears have any open looks from the three-point line. So good recognition. If they're not to take away the three, just pound it inside.
So that briefly stops the tidal wave, but the foul shot is missed here, and the score will stay 51-40. Dalton Young catches on the left wing. He has 11 points. Lehrer lets him shoot it. He'll rip the trigger on a three, but he'll miss it, and Hoagland grabs the rebound. Golden Bears trying to get it back down to a single-digit game. Grand Jeanette's up top, skips the bounce pass over to Fogarty. He'll power inside again, and he'll get fouled. And now this is what Bishop Garrigan wants, just attacking Fogarty inside.
Absolutely. No answer for them. Number 42 picks up the foul there. That's his second already. They're going to have to start rotating players in to guard Fogarty inside because Fogarty can really move that body, pick up those fouls right back at the free throw line.
So GTRA may eat into their bench here as Fogarty drains that one. That's Patrick Fiddler's third foul. He's one of only two players that are really expected to come off the bench in a close game for the Titans. Fogarty again, and he'll hit that one as Fiddler will stay in the game, at least briefly, as right now a timeout is called by Coach Huff here for GTRA. It's a 30-second timeout, so with that here, we'll go ahead and look for a quick word from the Iowa High School Athletic Association as it's 51-42 in favor of GTRA.
There's two things we can control every morning when we wake up. All right, there's two things. Don't take any athletic ability. It's attitude and effort. Let's get started here. Let's go. Let's have a day.
And we'll come back here into the gym after that quick word on our YouTube stream from the Iowa High School Athletic Association. 51-42 GTRA over Bishop Garrigan as Max Huff angles towards the far side of the court. 1:57 to go in this quarter. Young's on the right wing. They'll let him shoot it again, and this time he'll hit the three-pointer.
Well, he started the half by hitting a three-pointer. Got to get a face, at least a hand in the face of that shooter.
54-42, trying to answer is Noonan. That one deflects off the rim. It goes to Huff, right into the fast break. And before the shot, Noonan is going to foul Huff as he tried to jump stop in the lane.
Probably smart foul there by Ryan Noonan. Huff just explosive speed. That ball was on the floor, and he just bolted to that ball, beat Noonan to it. And Noonan doesn't want to give up the easy two.
Into the corner to Schnell. Around the perimeter goes to Heinrichs, over to the right. Huff spins away from Grand Jeanette. Max Huff on the jumper, misses, gets his own rebound, falls down. Ball rolls loose. Hovey dives on top of it, tries to shovel it to a teammate, but he throws it right to Max Huff. Dishes to Dalton Young, goes to the bucket, and he got fouled.
Wow, what a wild series there. Max Huff elevates. That kid must have a 30-inch vertical. He was way up there to get that rebound against the taller Jacob Lear, and then came crashing to the floor. Hovey crashes the floor on the loose ball, and then a Huff comes out of it. What a sequence.
Dalton Young misses on the first foul shot as Noonan heads to the bench. Drew Mahler returns for Bishop Garrigan. 54-42, 1:19 to go. Titans this season averaging just over 61.5 points per game, and they're already up to 55 here in the third quarter. As you can see why, they are very athletic. They're moving up the court quickly, and they're getting into transition as it'll be a substitution here for the Titans with Colin Hoffman coming into the ballgame.
And it's really impressive by them because it seems like Garrigan is putting some baskets in the bucket. It seems like they're crawling back in, but GTRA just extending it ever so slowly.
Hovey flips it up to Fogarty, near side of the court. Now Mahler into the lane, pivoting. Fogarty cuts baseline, misses off the rim. Lira rebounds, follows it back up. It rolls off to the left side. It's flipped back into play, but thrown right to Lira. Lira will try a floater from outside the lane. Fogarty taps it. Grand Jeanette tries to volleyball it. He knocks it out of bounds. And finally, it's back to GTRA after a crazy sequence again.
What a battle. Incredible. Max Huff was just in the locker room. He ran to the locker room to get some tape on his knee. He had some blood. Boy, he ran to that locker room like he was running the 100-meter dash. I don't know who's in the locker room, but he came. It was like a Superman switch. He came right out of the locker room with tape on his knee, and now he's back in the game.
Pass to Max Huff. Max Huff is blocked by Jacob Lear. It's right back into Huff's lap, though. On the baseline, goes all the way across to Schnell. Catch and fire three. He'll splash it in.
Oh, that's a big turnaround. Garrigan just had a series where they missed a couple point-blank buckets. If they could have got that to fall and then to come the other way and give up the three-pointer, that's going to hurt.
58-42, GTRA is pulling away, and a blocking foul here as Grand Jeanette brought it into the front court. As with 22 seconds left, it'll be Heinrichs picking up his third.
Yeah, good job by Grand Jeanette. Grand Jeanette is really playing hard. A moment ago, he skied to keep that ball alive on the rebound.
Fogarty, baseline cut to Mahler. It's long enough of Mahler's fingers and out of bounds.
Just a little bit of an errant pass there. Unfortunate turnover for the Bears at a time where they do not need it. They're going to have to make a little bit of run here in the fourth quarter to keep this game from getting too far out of reach.
We'll have to get some stops here on defense, and they'll have to unlock the three-point ball themselves, quite possibly. Schnell works outside to Fiddler, now to Huff, into the lane, rises for the foul line jumper, left it short, and there's the horn. 58-42 as we go to the fourth quarter. GTRA is 8 minutes away from moving on, but can the Golden Bears rally? We'll find out next on Hometown Radio, KLGA.
Tournament sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio, brought to you by these sports boosters.
Animal Medical Center. Trust Dr. Slegel with the care of your favorite family member.
PEPS, where friends don't let friends go thirsty.
Nutrient Ag Solutions of Irvington and Laverne.
Snap-on Tools, the most valued tool storage solutions in the world.
Sportsman's Corner, your power sports headquarters. Can-Am and Honda side-by-sides, ATVs, and motorcycles.
Capacious Brothers Incorporated, Pioneer Seed.
Carroll Implement of Laverne, serving area farming communities for over 50 years.
Farmers Co-op of Odison and Algona, offering Kent show feeds for all your livestock projects.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
And it's time for the fourth quarter here on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream. GTRA leads Bishop Garrigan 58-42. Golden Bears are going to need stops. They need that in the worst way. And they're going to need some buckets here quickly as well, trying to come back.
We'll see how GTRA plays that. Are they going to try to run clock? Sometimes that doesn't go so well for teams trying to run some clock. And looks like they're starting to run some clock right now.
Working the ball around the perimeter, attacking in the lane, Young, and he is fouled by Lehrer. That'll be Lehrer's third as Young will shoot two foul shots.
Well, Young has been really impressive this second half. Just when you think the Bears are going to get a stop, he's hit two big three-pointers, drained them, and that time, just when I think they're going to start running some clock, he takes it to the hole and picks up a foul on Lehrer.
You know, Young is kind of the forgotten man in this starting lineup for GTRA as he misses the foul shot. You've got Heinrichs and Max Huff, both averaging over 12.5 points a game. You've got Drew Schnell averaging 15.5 points per game and Corey Huff averaging over 10. So Young's the only non-double-digit starter, but, I mean, he's been in the center of everything tonight as he'll miss both foul shots, though.
Well, Grettinger, if they let up a little bit on defense here, Garrigan has to make their move in a hurry.
Into Fogarty, catches between two defenders, adjusts himself, and he will be fouled.
And I think that's an answer right there. Fogarty easily getting and-one calls here. This game, he gets that ball in the paint. He's so good that time he gets a little fadeaway bump. If he could have sunk that, he'd have an and-one situation. You know, keep looking for that. It's been there, and I think it still will be.
And Fogarty drains that at the foul line, making it 58-43. You know, what's been interesting here today as well as returning to the game is Corey Huff with his four fouls. Watching these two teams rebound of totally different styles. For Bishop Garrigan, it's kind of that size and length in their rebounding. For the Titans, they're rebounding because they're so athletic and crashing the boards.
Yeah, just when you think you have it secured, they come out of nowhere.
Heinrichs penetrating into the lane, sliding past Lehrer, but missing right at the bucket. That would have been an athletic layup if he had gotten that one to fall. Up the court to Hoagland, far side, trying to look inside to a posting up Fogarty, finds him, Fogarty into the lane again, rolls off, rebound though, Hovey. Hovey got it poked at, Hovey trying to navigate the baseline, getting it to Hoagland. Hoagland flips it up, no, follows it up, and this time it rolls in.
Oh, finally. Boy, it just seems like nothing can go in on this bucket down here. We've had so many point blank looks. They roll around and out. Hoagland finally gets the lid off here, starting the fourth quarter off.
First bucket of the night for the senior, 58-45 with 6:40 left in this one. The pass to the cutting Max Huff, drops the ball, picks it back up, kicks it out. Young, right angle three, bang!
Oh, he is on fire. Young being so big this second half for the Titans, making the Bears pay big.
Dalton Young has 15 points, and he's got his teammates doing the gritty on the sideline. 6:18 to go. Jacob Lehrer over to Grand Jeanette. Now far corner to Hovey. Pump fakes, drives, stopped. He'll flip it up anyways. Comes up short off the front of the rim, and it's picked up by Young. Huff up the near side. Huff, sidearm pass to Young. Young off the glass, and he scores it again. Dalton Young is taking over this ball game, and it's 63-45.
Oh, he's flowing. And meanwhile, the Bears, they're getting the ball inside. Just no one can knock it down. Everybody wants to win the game on their own. Hobie had a nice look inside. Just nothing going down.
Ball's kicked out of bounds. It's a timeout and a full timeout, as we'll take one as well. Back in 60 seconds on Hometown Radio, KLGA, and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio. Brought to you by these sports boosters.
Heim Endeavors, proud supporter of Bishop Garrigan Athletics.
Miller Construction, complete construction. Contact Scott or Lynn today.
Doctors Klepper and Trainer Family Vision Clinic. Let's talk about your eyes.
Miller Sports and Service, your local Kawasaki, Himco, and ATV dealer, along with Aluma Trailers.
Prism Wealth Advisors, your roadmap to financial freedom.
Cook's Scrap Iron at 900 East McGregor Street in Algona.
Murphy Realty and Management, serving Algona and surrounding communities.
AK's Chrome Kitchen, friendly service, family environment.
All sponsors of this broadcast.
.553 left in this one, and the Titans are finding their stroke. It's 63-45. Dalton Young's been shooting the rock well for GTRA, as he right now has 17 points. Corey Huff with 19, and the Titans are 6 minutes of good basketball away from moving on. Golden Bears trying to muster one last run here. Grand Jeanette flips it to Hobie at the foul line, bounces it to the cutting Fogarty, sandwiched between two players, fights it up anyways, and it bounces off. Lear rebounds, fades away, misses off the glass, and it's rebounded by Corey Huff.
I just don't know how those baskets are not going in. That was a good look by Fogarty, good look by Lear. They just won't go through the hoop.
Jacob Lear has been stuck on 21 points here for quite a little bit. Fogarty with 13 for Bishop Garrigan. Max Huff dishing it. Threw it away, though, as Young couldn't corral it, and that'll be a turnover.
All right. I mean, I know this didn't go. You'd hope that the Bears were going to come out in the second half and get it close and put some pressure on GTRA, but they can make a couple baskets, maybe put a little pressure on still. Lots of time left, 5 minutes, but they got to get moving.
Hobie has it. Hobie trying to hook his way around Heinrichs. An offensive foul here against Bishop Garrigan.
Yeah, it's been an interesting game. That's a good call by the official. He saw it clear as a day. That was a hook. But, you know, the first half called so tight. Second half, a little more physical, a little more bumping and grinding and getting away with stuff.
Huff passes left. Underhand give to Heinrichs, into the lane, jump stopping, swatted by Fogarty. Hobie flips it up to Fogarty. Fogarty runs the court. He'll kiss it off the glass and score it.
There we go. That is a really nice breath of fresh air for a team that really needs it.
So Fogarty right now has 15 points. Heinrich being pestered up top right now, gets rid of the basketball, over to Dalton Young. Bounce pass back into the near corner to Heinrichs, and Hoagland got a little too aggressive that time and ran into him, and it's 1-1 time here for GTRA.
But I do appreciate coming out of the timeout. The Bears have really come out with some defensive intensity. They want to claw their way back in this. Will they have enough time?
Time not the Golden Bears' friend with 4:31 left as Heinrichs splashes that first foul shot through. 64-47 right now. Titans leading.
Heinrichs wearing that wrist brace. He's got his wrist taped up, and you can see why. He is fearless and a little bit reckless going to the hoop. He sacrifices that body. I suspect that's how he hurt himself.
Misses the second as he splits the pair. Lear got the rebound. Grandjeanette gives to Hoagland. Now Fogarty back to the bucket. Dishes to a cutting Hobie. Hobie ran into all kinds of traffic, but he'll get bailed out here by a foul.
You know, and I just realized that it's been physical down low, but the Titans for GTRA, every time the Bears get it inside the second half, they have done a fantastic job of collapsing their defense. As soon as you have a little bit of daylight, there are three Titans smothering you, as it happened to Hobie right there. Good job by Hobie getting the contact and going to the foul line.
Hobie will shoot, looking for his first point of the night. And he's perfect on the foul shot there, 64-48. Titans still leading Bishop Garrigan. Hobie again as the student section screams in the background. And he got that one as well, making it 64-49.
He's got to feel good about that. Tough to shoot those free throws with the student section cheering in you.
Huff, bounce pass Heinrichs, cut right along the baseline, and he got the wide open layup. Huff has been just dishing out the ball tonight.
Yeah, he's very calm, too. Just Just easy going out there.
He finds those seams as Hobie will try three. Launched it long. Flipped back into play, but right to Hoagland. And now another foul will be called.
All right. Well, Hoagland's going to be shooting some free throws. Good free throw shooter. The more times the Bears can score with the clock stopped, advantage.
Fourth foul against Heinrichs. Heinrichs and Corey Huff both have four fouls. As Hoagland at the line on the 1-1. That one rattles out. Mira tips to himself, but he went over the back.
Oh, that's too bad. I thought that was going to be a big rebound by Jacob Lear and 2 points. Now we got to go to the other end and shoot free throws. That's going to be hard for the Bears. They want to get fouled, but they're down big. They also can't commit fouls because the next one's going to be in the double bonus.
Yeah, both teams with 9 fouls right now as Young will shoot again from the free throw line. Young again having a marvelous night so far as he drains that one and gets up to 18 points.
Well, his second half has been fantastic. Without him, this game's going to be a lot closer. I think he and Max Huff have really played a very solid second half.
And he'll rattle that foul shot in again. You spend so much energy focusing on Max Huff and Drew Schnell and the rest of the team that maybe you don't always account for Young. Lear, corner pocket triple. That one is off the back of the iron this time, and Heinrichs rebounds. 3:40 to go. Whips it up to Young. Nice bounce pass. Oh, a second pass, and that is laid in by Schnell. That was just a quick touch that time by Corey Huff right to Schnell on the extra pass.
Just sharing the love on Valentine's Day with the teammates there. Either guy could have scored the 2 points.
Hoagland, he'll try a three-pointer on the near side. Came up short, and Huff skies for the rebound. 70-49, Huff a long outlet pass, sends the cheerleaders scattering, and it's out of bounds.
Yeah, I can't remember who was the quarterback on the football team, but after watching that pass zip down the full length of the floor, I'm guessing it was probably Max Huff.
Your guess would be correct.
I do recall that game. It did not go well for the Bears.
Yeah, Titans had quite the football team this year, and now they have quite the basketball team. Hoagland hangs, misses at the rim. Lear follows it up, and he'll score to make it 70-51.
Even so, Hoagland couldn't get that basket to fall. It is uncanny how many point-blank shots have not fallen for the Bears the second half.
Corey Huff turns around, gives it to Young. 2:50 to go. Young down the center of the lane, off the glass to the right. Fogarty rebounds. Flips it up ahead to Hobie. Hobie crosses over. Heinrichs stays in front. Hobie misses. Ball swatted out of bounds, and it will stay with the Golden Bears.
And another point-blank look for the Bears that doesn't fall by Hobie there. And that was the first time this whole second half that the Bears have had a chance for any sort of transition points. The Titans just not giving up any transition buckets.
The Titans will take a timeout with 2:39 left, a full timeout, so we will take it as well. 70-51, GTRA leads Bishop Garrigan.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
Kemna Quick Lane is the easy, fast, and convenient way to get an oil change.
No appointment needed, just show up.
Oil changes start at $59.95 for the 6-quart basic package, including inspection, fluid top-off, air and cabin filter check. They can also rotate your tires and replace your air filter or cabin filter for additional charges.
The Quick Lane is open 7:30 to 5, Monday through Friday, and 7:30 to noon on Saturdays. Don't stress when your vehicle says change the oil now. Just drive to Kemna Quick Lane, Highway 18 West, Algona.
No appointment needed.
Kemna cares.
As we come back quickly here after the timeout, Bishop Garrigan turns it over and the Titans get it back with 2:36 on the clock. 70-51 right now. GTRA has a tight grip on this one. Baseline jumper on the way from Young. That's a little long. Huff sails in and tips the rebound right to Young. Well, Huff is still hustling here up by 19.
Well, that's a perfect example of what you said earlier, Tyler. The way they get rebounds is not the traditional way to get rebounds. They're just quick. Speed is killing right now. They're just everywhere.
Hobie will knock that pass away. And actually, that was not even touched by Hobie. Schnell rose, and he threw it towards the baseline, and it went out of bounds.
Yeah, I thought Hobie got a finger on it, but you're right. Yeah, that was just an errant pass. He changed his mind mid-air.
So going to the bench is Jacob Lear and Jack Grandjeanette. And that may be the last time we see Lear in a Golden Bear uniform as he checks out with 23 points. leading the way for Bishop Garrigan. Cal Berkey in right now for the Golden Bears. Logan Nemers as well. Nemers will catch in the post. He'll lay it off the glass and he'll score it.
Boy, something Nemers does so well is catch that ball and keep it up with his body, protect himself, and go up smooth to the hoop. That's a pretty quick move for the big man.
Huff on the elbow. We'll hand it off to Heinrichs here with 1:42 on the clock. GTRA looking for that date with North Iowa on Thursday. Over to the left, Huff. Huff, high pass inside. Corey Huff grabs it, gives it back to Max Huff. He'll fall down as he's shooting the jumper, and Hobie grabs the rebound as it missed off to the left. Hobie jogs it into the front court, bullets it inside Mahler. Mahler drops it, and it's picked up by Schnell. Schnell had it knocked out of his hands. Berkey tried to save it, but it's out of bounds off the Golden Bears.
You know, and that's just been what's the bread and butter here for GTRA. All season, I'm going to guess, is just these ferocious guards just never quit. You never get a breath of fresh air on your own offense. There is always someone in your shorts. Nothing comes easy against these Titans with their good defense.
Timeout is called with 1:17 on the clock, 70-53 the score. So with the timeouts being spent, we'll take another one ourselves and come back here in 60 seconds on Hometown Radio, KLGA.
At Wiffles Hybrids, they're completely focused on developing and producing the very best seed corn on the planet. A snack they've been polishing for more than 70 years, right here in the heart of the Corn Belt. Wiffles Hybrid, one thing done right. For more information, contact Rich Rosenmeyer, Dale Lappy, or Mitchell Carroll at JDR Seed of Wesley, 515-341-2452, or visit wiffles.com.
Signworks Inc. has solutions for your signage needs, as well as vehicle graphics in all sizes, from a logo on the window to wrapping your entire vehicle, whether it's a banner, magnetic, or building signage. Signworks Inc. strives to provide fast, friendly service. They also are a source for custom screen printing on garments. If they can't provide you with what you need, they will direct you to who can. They are your local resource for signage and screen printing using your ideas and their creativity. Signworks Inc., 1613 East Locust Street, Algona, 295-95. Or email info@signworksinc.com.
And we are back here in the fourth quarter as Young fades away. He'll miss that shot, but it kicks all the way over to Corey Huff, who gets the offensive rebound. Golden Bears have emptied the bench. Nathan Marin in, Nate Bronk for the first time tonight, as well as Berkey, Nemers, and Mahler. We're under a minute to go here as the Titans are getting revenge for last season. It was the Golden Bears in this position last year. This year it'll be the Titans in position to take the win over the Golden Bears. Right now, GTRA will just hold the ball, and Bishop Garrigan will not even contest.
Yeah, there's still a lot of time left. 30 seconds on the clock to just stand there and watch the clock tick. Let's play some ball. There we go. Now we're moving.
Young dribbled a little bit towards the left there as the Golden Bears half-heartedly defend. Hand off to Heinrichs here as the Titans will let their starters run the clock away. Max Huff, who had a nice game tonight, dribbles to the left, flips it back to the right to Drew Schnell. Down to 15 seconds to go. Well, Golden Bears are going to end the season on a four-game losing streak here after a lot of progress in the second half of the year. As the final 10 seconds tick away in this one, GTRA shows what they're made of, and they win this in their home gym. 70-53, the final score, as there's the final buzzer. Titans knock off the Golden Bears here tonight. Well, we'll take a final timeout, and we'll come back in a couple minutes. Wrap it up with some final stats and analysis next on Hometown Radio KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
More sports boosters making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Redding Gravel and Excavating, serving Algona and the surrounding area since 1948.
Erpeling Boyd & Company, CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Central Financial Services, where you belong.
Shoemaker Well and Water Care, they know water from the bottom to the tap.
Red Power Team in Bancroft, Corwith, West Bend, and Humboldt.
Grand Jeanette Jewelry and Merle Norman Cosmetics, offering sales, appraisals, design, and on-site repairs.
Bob Becker Construction and Wesley Lumber, always looking through the eyes of their customers.
State Line Cooperative, real people, real pride.
Bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
When you buy appliances locally, you're supporting your friends and neighbors. When you buy appliances locally, you're helping the local economy. When you buy appliances locally, they'll be serviced by someone you know and trust. Get exceptional service every time when you buy from North Iowa Appliance Center. For almost 45 years, they've been carrying Maytag, KitchenAid, Whirlpool, and Amana, the best appliances on the market today. Inventory is coming in weekly, so check out the store to see what they have in stock. North Iowa Appliance Center, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears run out of steam in the second half tonight as they fall to the GTRA Titans by a final score of 70-53. I'm Tyler Lance alongside Beanie Bodie. I'll tell you what, partner, very competitive first quarter, very competitive first half. Even the first few minutes of the third quarter, kind of a few punches traded back and forth, but it felt like there was so much pressure for the Golden Bears to stay with a very athletic GTRA team, and eventually the well just burst and the Titans just played their game of ball and were able to pull away at the end.
Yes, speed kills, and that one out tonight. The Grettinger, Terrell, Ruffin, Ayrshire, just a much quicker team than the Bears, and they kept making the Bears pay over and over again, and not in necessarily the ways that you would expect it. Not necessarily on steals for layups with the speed, but different ways. Offensive rebounding. They found their way to a lot of offensive rebounds in the second half, and their ball movement. Just good cuts to the basket. Max Huff really played a great second half, finding cutters to the basket, and that speed really started to wear down the Bishop Garrigan Bears. They just lost a lot of energy and didn't have enough energy to muster up the big comeback that they needed. You know, there was an opportunity there coming out of halftime. Game was a 7-point game that the Bears could have put a little pressure on them if they put together a little rally. But GTRA comes out of halftime, gets a big 3-pointer from the guy who really did it all for them besides Max Huff. Every time you thought they might get a stop, Dalton Young was open for a three-pointer and just made the Bears pay over and over again and just kept stretching that lead out. But so credit to the Titans, boy. They played a great game. They really impressed me how they stayed calm and composed the whole game. Every time Garrigan got the ball inside, did a fantastic job of collapsing, putting a lot of pressure on the inside game of the Bears. And, boy, that ball just never seemed to go through the hoop in the second half. Even though the Bears got it inside, good looks at the hoop, just wouldn't go down the cylinder.
You're right, Beanie, is, again, Bishop Garrigan loses this one 70-53 in the final score. And I'll tell you what, I was impressed. GTRA got in some early foul trouble, but they weathered their way through that. They withstood the foul trouble, and someone else stepped up. You know, Corey Huff picked up his fourth foul pretty early there in the third quarter. And like you said, Dalton Young picked up the slack, and he did a lot of the scoring. Wasn't a huge scoring night for Max Huff, but he affected the game in other ways. Got some steals on defense, created transition opportunities, made the Golden Bears uncomfortable. So, not really even the Titans' best game necessarily tonight, but they took that early hit from Bishop Garrigan, they weathered the foul trouble storm, and they pulled through at the end.
I thought in the second half, with everybody being in foul trouble for the Titans, I thought that they were going to let off the gas a little bit physically underneath because they didn't want to keep picking up fouls, but boy, they definitely did not. They just kept on fearlessly banging bodies down below, risking those foul calls, and the fouls were called. I thought Garrigan would get easier looks at the basket, but Fogarty inside, Lehrer inside, Hovey inside. Every time they got that ball in there, the Grettinger defense just collapsed on them. And even though we were much, much bigger, we just couldn't find a way to get that ball up and in the hoop.
So taking a look at a couple quick final scoring numbers for tonight. Jacob Lehrer has 23 for the Golden Bears, while Drew Fogarty scores 15. On the Titans side of things, their leading scorers consisted of Dalton Young with 19, Corey Huff with 19, Drew Schnell and Eric Heinrichs both with 10. So GTRA moves on. They will face North Iowa right here at this gym coming up on Thursday night, and what should be an interesting matchup in that one. Titans looking to make a nice run here in the postseason after having three losing seasons in a row prior to this one, but a lot of talent and experience came together this season, and it's finally starting to gel for the Titans. On the Golden Bears side of things, they wrap up with a 6-16 record, and you know, it was a long season, it was a learning season, and it was a huge process this year for the Golden Bears. I think Golden Bear fans can be encouraged that they played a lot better in the second half of the season and down the stretch, picked up a few more wins. Obviously, though, this team still has a long way to go before they'll be in contention for a game like this. A lot of progress that needs to be made over the offseason and improvements that need to come for this team.
Oh, for sure. Yeah, and they've got, they've got a lot of young players that they're working on. You know, you saw Logan Emmers come in there at the end of the game, do some nice things off the bench, really handle that ball. Like, he's underestimated as a big man. You see him for his size, but he's very nimble. He can handle that ball well. He's got good hands. So he's a player that's going to come in next year to replace Jacob Lear, no doubt, losing the 6'6 senior. It's going to be a big loss for the Bears. He's just played a whale of a season, leading scorer for the Bears, playing big inside. You know, started the game tonight, looked like he was going to dominate. I was hoping he'd go off for 40 points tonight. You know, he started, got the first points of the game for the Bears, and looked like he was going to be unstoppable. But, again, credit to the Titans for finding a way to defend the 6'6 big man. But, yeah, they'll lose Jacob Lear. But, as I said, Logan Nemers, you know, rearing up right behind. Drew Muller, the freshman, played significantly this year. You know, he's another player they'll look to in the future for coming in. Hoagland's another senior. They're losing. He made a good bucket tonight, really came on strong the second half of the season. Hoagland played great in that four-city game. That was probably, looking back, probably the biggest win for the Bears on their season. That was a big moment over there for those seniors at four-city, getting that win. And Hollis Bodie played sparingly. So three seniors they're saying goodbye to here, and a lot of young players returning for the Bears. So definitely something to build on for the future.
So it'll be tough, especially to replace Lear, like you said. That's not just going to be a plug and play, but Golden Bears will try to use some of that young talent that they have coming up to fill that hole and make another step next season as they rebuild the team. As a lot of talent cycle through this program here the past couple of years, now you've kind of gotten to the spot where the talent's turned over, now it's the young guys' turn. So we saw year one of that this year, and year two will be coming up next season. We'll see what the Golden Bears can do next to follow this up. Just a quick look at our upcoming coverage, as tomorrow we will have Bishop Garrigan basketball against West Bend Mallard, the girls' game coming up at 7 o'clock. Also on our sister station, Home Country Radio, KLGZ, Brian Wilson will be on the call as North Union basketball faces Sioux Central in what should be a good girls' game. So that'll be our coverage for tomorrow night. Video streaming will be available as well for the Bishop Garrigan versus West Bend Mallard game. So that's all coming up as the Golden Bear boys wrap up their season. Once again, final score, GTRA 70, and Bishop Garrigan, 53.
Don't let concern.